Finally tonight, recently 6.30's Max Futcher was invited to sit down with tennis great Andre Agassi, who at one point in his celebrated career was more highly strung than the proverbial tennis racket. But Max tells us he was actually struck by how much at ease these days Agassi is.
What's up?
Hi.
How are you? Welcome.
Mixing with the kids. These days, this is a typical day at the office for Andre Agassi. 5 years after retiring, the man considered to be among the greatest to ever hold a racket is still sharp on the court and off it. The game which made him still surrounds him. Surprising for the sport he famously concedes he hated.
Yes. In your book, you talked a bit about tennis being a lot like life, like every point, every game, every set can be a turning point. And you talked about life after tennis and made you ponder life after death. So what's it been like? What have you found?
Well, it is interesting to do something your whole life and have it one day just come to an end. You know, you do something your whole life and then you go, what's life going to look like without it? And it's the unknown, really. And so I kind of compare it to the death. And for me, I had great anticipation. I didn't know if it was going to be like Christmas every day because I all of a sudden don't have to worry about the physical and emotional and mental dramas and or if it was going to be you know, quite a lonely experience trying to reconnect with a different life, and I found it to be somewhere in between.
Much of this afterlife is consumed by his charities, helping less fortunate children in education and in life. Of course, there's tennis too. Recently hitting up with the Longines future tennis aces at the French Open, it was about this age when Andre was under enormous pressure to perform from his father.
What do you see when you see these young kids who are so focused and so determined? Do you see a bit of yourself in them, and does that worry you a little bit about them?
Well, I hope I don't see a little bit of myself. Sometimes you do, because you see a child who's either putting unnecessary pressure on themselves, parents that are putting unnecessary pressure on their kids. But in most cases, I see the optimism in it. I see what this is teaching them about themselves.
How do you see Wimbledon this year?
I think it could be a breakthrough for Murray. I think it's a surface that he's very comfortable on. He has a lot of pressure on him as well mentally. But I like Djokovic. I don't see why Djokovic can't translate across the board. Clay, grass, hard. He really could do something special this year.
Looking at those players that you've talked about there, I mean, you were always known for your flamboyance and you know, kept people interested because of your character. Do we have characters in the sport right at the moment?
I don't know really what made me character besides the fact that I kind of felt what I felt on the outside. I mean, you could see if I was struggling or if I was having a good day. And I think there's a lot of those guys out there still. I mean, I think there's a lot of different elements to appreciate about what the game has to offer right now. I mean, to watch Federer make it look so easy, to watch a Nadal with his intensity, to watch a Murray with sort of his disposition out there. It's, you know, games change, times change, it's more competitive. You can't just get away with as much as you used to if you're not on your focused game every day. And sometimes that creates a barrier between the fans and the player.
You gonna come down and see us in Australia?
I hope so. I really miss it down there. I've had some of my greatest memories on the court and off the court in Australia, and I look forward to getting back there. I hope it can be this upcoming year. But to break away from the family once we're back in school.
And what about the kids? After you and Steffi, that's a pretty good pedigree.
No, my daughter plays once a week, you know, but my son's in the baseball, and me as a parent and Steph as a parent, we've been there. I don't think anymore.